एक्सरसाइज रिमेनिंग फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर नेचर वेजिटेशन एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ. यस परीक्षित, परीक्षित इट्स नॉट योर पीरियड. परीक्षित दैट मैसेज इट्स फॉर द Yes, question answers. Let's discuss regarding as an exercise of a natural vegetation and wildlife. Natural vegetation and wildlife. So multiples of seven, raise your hands. Multiples of seven, raise your hands. Multiples of seven, raise your hands. So Gushan, first question is here. First question. To which one of the following types of vegetation does the rubber belong to? Rubber belong to. Very good. Excellent answer. Tropical evergreen forest. Tropical evergreen forest, which do not shed their leaves in a particular month of the year. Yes, Ishani, second question is here. Cinchona trees are found in a Cinchona trees are found in areas receiving the annual rainfall. Annual rainfall. Yes, Ishani.
Sir, A option, 100 centimeters.
100 centimeters. More than 100 centimeters. Very good. More than 100 centimeters as an annual rainfall. You can send your message in a chat. Those who are having as a problem of a mic, they can send their message in a chat. Third question. This is as in which of the following state is the Simlipal Bioreserve is located? Simlipal Bioreserve located at a which state? So correct answer is a yes. Send your options. Odisha, very good. Tanveen, Tanveen, Ishani and Janvi ji are given correct answer as a Odisha, known for the location of and Gaurav also. Location of a Simlipal Bioreserve. Fourth is, which one of the following bioreserves of India is not included in the World Network of Bioreserves? World Network, which are associated with the protection of those species of animals which are coming from other nations, means as a migratory birds. So answer is a Manas. Japji, Janvi, G are given correct answer. Manas, M-A-N-A-S. Manas in Assam. M-A-N-A-S. It is known as the Kanishkari also. Manas known for the home of a rhinos. Rhinoceros in India. M-A-N-A-S. Clear? Next as a question answers. What factors are responsible for the distribution of plants and animals in India? Plants and animals, land, surface areas. In different number of lands and different types of wildlife species are present. First as a land. Second as temperature. Temperature. Temperature, precipitation. That's why as in tropical evergreen forests, as a more diverse vegetation, more diverse biodiversity as existed comparatively in a tropical deciduous forest. Land, climate, precipitation. Land, climate, precipitation. And next, as a photoperiod, got a very good photoperiod, sunlight, known for the location growth of a biodiversity. Clear? Second question as a what is a bioreserve? Those protected lands which are known for the protection of a species, wildlife species of animals at their natural habitats. Those protected lands where the wildlife species of animals are living at their natural habitats. Natural habitats. Their examples, you can write as an example any one of the category, examples from a national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, and bird sanctuaries. Number of national parks, the examples we discuss as a, for example, Simlipal in Odisha, Sariska in Rajasthan, Corbett in Uttarakhand, Sundarbans in West Bengal, Gir Forest in Gujarat, Kanha in a Madhya Pradesh Wildlife Sanctuary, Kanheri in a Maharashtra, Periyar in Kerala, Rajaji in Uttarakhand, Dudhwa in Uttar Pradesh, Dachigam in a Jammu and Kashmir, Manas, Kaziranga, and Assam. So many examples are there, right? Any two. Which one is easier for you? So name two animals having as a habitat in a tropical and a mountain type of vegetation. In tropical weather conditions, animals which are present in a tropical conditions as monkey, elephant, tiger. Very good, Gaurav. Monkey, elephant, tigers in a tropical conditions, in mountain areas as a snow leopard, yak, panda are the examples of a mountain vegetation. Clear? Next, as a name, different types, distinguish in between of a flora and fauna. Flora denotes as a plant species. Fauna denotes as a animal species. So factors which are affecting as a these two types as a differently, you can distinguish. Next, as a tropical evergreen and a tropical deciduous forest, you can distinguish these two on a basis of a rainfall receiving in these two tropical evergreen and tropical deciduous. Second, as why we call as an evergreen and a deciduous. Evergreen because they green throughout the year, do not shed their leaves in a particular month. Whereas a tropical deciduous forest, tropical deciduous forest, they shed their leaves in a before of winters. Tropical evergreen has generally lies in areas receiving as an annual rainfall. Their areas rainfall, their speciality, their species of trees in both the categories, species of animals. And fifth difference, as the tropical evergreen forests are known for a hardwood, which is has a less commercial purposes, whereas a tropical deciduous forest produced a softwood, which is high demanded for timber industry, for furnitures. Clear? Five differences in both the categories. Next, as a name, different types of vegetation found in India and describe the vegetation of high altitudes, means mountain vegetation. With their height, what kind of variations are occurred with the number of species of trees? In tropical deciduous till 1000 to the 3000 as a coniferous forest, what type of species of trees are found in a coniferous forest? And afterwards, the 3000 to 3500 as alpine vegetation, their specialties. And afterwards, as a 3500 to 5000 meters, the type of vegetation as growing in such areas. Clear? You have to explain about the only one as mountain vegetation. First, the name of all the types of vegetation, then mountain vegetation only. Clear? Fifth, you have to write about what factors are responsible for the plants and animals which are becoming as endangered. Plants and animals. For example, the first is the loss of habitats. Due to the commercialization of agriculture, land required for agriculture purposes, which leads to the loss of habitats for animals. Loss of habitats for animals. Clear? Industrialization leads to the loss of habitats for animals. Developmental projects like as a construction of a dams responsible for this. Industries are responsible for a destruction of a natural habitat for animals. So first reason, loss of the habitats. Second, as a human predation due to as a hunting and a poaching, which leads to the killing of a wildlife species of animals. A large number of wildlife species are decreasing day by day because of a hunting and poaching, illegal smuggling of the body parts of animals, which leads to it. Third, as a excessive use of pesticides and pollution. Pesticides and pollution is also responsible for decreasing the number of wildlife species and affecting the biodiversity. Fourth, you can write about negligence or the wastage of a natural wealth. And last question, as a why has India a rich heritage of flora and fauna? The factors affecting as a natural vegetation. Factors affecting natural vegetation in detail. Clear? Factors affecting natural vegetation in detail. So you have to attempt questions on your notebook answer the questions briefly. answer the questions briefly and long questions means 2, 4, 5, 6 is mandatory to attempt on your notebooks. Today is a Saturday. Your copies, it should be as a ready till the Friday. Clear? 7 days are there. It's more than enough. You have to ready your notebooks till Friday. Yes, Dhairya?
Sir.
Dhairya ji. Poverty. Poverty as a challenge for our nation, for our country, In existing population at in present, there are a 29% of people are under poverty. 29% of people. How can we distinguish that? The people are under poverty. Poverty is a state. It is a situation. Poverty is a situation in which a person unable to complete their basic needs. A person which can't complete their basic needs. Basic needs are food, shelter, and clothing. Food, shelter, and clothing is considered as under poverty. This is considered as poverty. Yes, Jia, 32 rupees, but it is not as applicable in all the countries. They explain the poverty as per their existing conditions. Conditions which are prevailing in that particular country. It's due to the per capita income. All over the world, all the countries of the world, they are not possessing as a equal per capita income. It's due to as a natural wealth, natural resources. Unequal distribution of a natural resources responsible for unequal distribution of income. Next year, you will learn about the development. The World Bank categorizes the world economies based upon a per capita income, in which if our per capita income, the annual per capita income, the average income earned by the individuals, if it will be as a more than the 50,000 annually, then it will be considered as the India, it will be as a life under the developed nations. But our present situation as the 27,000 as our national income. Per capita income of every person, the average person has earned the 27,000 as annually. 27,000 as annually. We can divide it with the 12. It will be as a near about a 2.5. 2.4. We can say as a 2400 rupees, that person which has earning in a month, 2400 divided by the 30. 2400 divided by the 30 means as 80 rupees per head. 80 rupees per head, sorry, per family. Here we are talking about a family, that 80 rupees as a per family. But when those families which are possessing as a more than the one kid, 2, 4, 7 kids in such families, due to as a large in size of population, large size of a population, the annual or available income resources are not adequate. That's why the India has lies under the poverty. India lies under the poverty. Poverty is a situation in which a person is unable to get their minimum basic needs of life, that is the food, shelter, and clothing. When a larger section of the people in an economy are deprived of these basic necessities, that economy is said to be the mass poverty. Mass poverty, not only as a one person, a large section of a population, they categorize under the, or they can't complete as their basic necessities. It is known as the mass poverty. At present, 29% of our total population living the under poverty. They are living as the under poverty, below poverty. To the estimation of a poverty, we are using as a poverty line. We are using as the poverty line for the estimation of a poverty. To estimate the level of the poverty in economy, we are using as the, we use the poverty line. Poverty line means, for example, as earlier as Gia said, Gia 28 roll number said, as under 32 rupees a family or a person which is spending as a 32 rupees in a day below is considered as the poverty, is considered as under poverty. It will be considered as under poverty. So this may be as a vary from country to country as per the existing situation. The poverty is used in two ways. Poverty term used in a two ways. One as a relative poverty and absolute poverty. Relative poverty means relative poverty. Yes, we will discuss in a later as what methods are there which we use for the estimation of a poverty, Gia. So relative poverty, under relative poverty, the economic conditions of different regions, or countries compared, the per capita income and the national income and national income are the two indicators. These are the two indicators of relative poverty. So anybody, can anybody explain what it mean? How can we estimate regarding as a per capita income and national income? Yes, anybody? How can we estimate, how can we calculate the per capita income? Per capita income is average income, which is calculated by the total income by the three sectors, primary, secondary, tertiary. Total income earned from primary, secondary, and tertiary divided by total population. It is as the average income. Sum of, for example, through which you calculated as a mean, sum of total observations divided by the total number of observations. So total income earned from a primary, secondary, tertiary divided by total population. This is known as the average income or per capita income. This is known as the average income or per capita income. Clear? And a national income, which is also an indicator of a relative poverty. It is also a indicator of a relative poverty. National income calculated or estimated through income earned from a three sectors, primary, secondary, tertiary, which is also known as a GDP. Income earned within an economy through three sectors plus with addition to the income earned from abroad. Income earned from abroad. Those parents which are moving towards as abroad in a foreign countries, their earnings are from other countries, but they are spending on their families in our country. It is included under the national income. It is included under the national income. Income earned from three sectors. Income earned from a primary, secondary, tertiary, plus income earned from abroad, through which we can calculate the national income. We can calculate the national income. Clear? According to the report of a United Nations organization, those individuals which are spending $725 annually to complete their basic needs are considered the above poverty line. They are considered as the above poverty line. Families spending the $725 as the estimation. This was as a United Nations statement in relation to the poverty. Clear? This has two as the relative, and that poverty, it can be estimated to the per capita income and national income. Second is the absolute poverty. Absolute poverty refers to the measure of poverty, keeping in view the per capita income, intake of calories, per capita income, intake of calories, and minimum level of consumption. According to the absolute poverty means, if a person has living in a rural areas, it is needs as a 2400 calories in a day. 2400 calories. So for the completion of a 2400 calories, so total money which is spent by the individual, if it is as not adequate, such calories are not completing to the individual, that person has considered under poverty. And in urban areas, as 2100 calories, because in a rural areas, manual labor works, laborious work as a more comparatively the cities, 2400 calories for a rural areas and 2100 calories for a urban areas. 2100 calories for a urban areas. 21, but we can say, clear? 2400. Some of the individuals which are not taking as adequate diet, their parents, poverty refers to the measuring of a poverty, keeping in view total per capita income spending for caloric consumption. In rural areas, if a person can't complete the existing income as 2400 calories, means a person is under poverty. In urban areas, as per the available income, a person can't complete their 2100 calories in a day, that person has considered as absolute poverty. That person has considered as under the absolute poverty. Absolute poverty. Clear? 2100 calories in urban areas, 2400 calories in rural areas. For an estimation of a poverty, there are basically the two methods are opted. One as an expenditure method. Expenditure means jitna kharcha kiya ja raha hai, the money which are spending, expenditure method. Expenditure method. And second, income method. GR 28 roll number, you given as example of an income method. 32 rupees in a day. A person which is spending as a 32 rupees in a day for their basic necessities. Below of it as the poverty, above of it as the exclusion of a poverty section. Two methods are used for estimation of a poverty. First, expenditure method. Expenditure method. Under expenditure method, first of all, the minimum nutritional food requirements, minimum nutritional food requirements for survival is estimated. Means the total number, Gia, she's living in, Gia Chopra living in a urban area, she require as a 2100 calories in a day. 2100 calories in a day. So for a 2100 calories, so what kind of the items she choose? What kind of the items she choose for a completion of their needs? For example, she's taking as a 8 chapatis in a day. As per the average, 120 calories in each chapati. 120 into the 8. 120 into the 8. 960 calories. 960 calories. Now as a remaining, as a near about 1140 calories remaining. She's taking as a? No. She will not take as a pizza, Gushan. And we as estimate the number of such goods which are taking by the GR throughout the day to completion of their 2400 calories in a day. 2400 calories in a day. Afterwards, we will check that the food value is converted to the calories. Food value, whatever the food used by the GI throughout the day, their value converted into the calories. Afterwards, the caloric value of food is then converted into the money. Means the total money which is spending by the GI Chopra for purchasing of such materials. Such materials throughout their those materials which are used by the GR to complete their caloric consumption, it will be as a converted into the money in currency, rupees. And afterwards, as the fourth, the minimum amount of money which is as required for purchasing of a cloth and a necessities and her other necessities is added to the money value of the food. First, whatever the goods used by the GI in a day, dairy use in a day, we can use example of a dairy. Number of goods used by the dairy in a day. Afterwards, such goods converted into the caloric value. Afterwards, the such number of goods for which as how much as a money spent by the dairy throughout the day, converted into the money, currency, in rupees. Clear? Then fourth level, you have to ask first, jo food ke upar spend kiya, so side mein rakh do. Second as money which is spending over a clothing items, clothes. Then third as other requirements for his survival on a shelter, on a clothing, on food, whatever the expenditure is there. Jitna total kharcha hua, then we their estimation, their collection.